You're listening to the Edge Radio program, a show so hot, your radio might catch on fire. Points expressed on The Edge are not necessarily those of this radio station, its staff, management, or other sponsors. It's time for The Edge Radio broadcast as we discover the truth together. Within the continental U.S., call toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or locally here in Indiana, 359-5593. That's toll-free 1-800-996-9638. 9638 or locally at 359-5593. You can find out more about our guests and topics by logging on to The Edge's website, theedgeam.com. That's theedgeam.com.
Thursdays on The Edge.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Andy Radford. This is the Edges UK studio, and welcome to another Thursday show. Coming up on the show this week, Edge correspondent Mike Eastwood has a superb audio and video presentation about the United Kingdom ID card. Gina Romano, the Edge correspondent and researcher who is responsible for looking into the growing problem of organised gang stalking and electronic warfare against innocent people, continues her investigations later on in the show. And Edge correspondent Frank Lordy talks about the holographic rapture. If you're interested in becoming a voluntary Edge correspondent, just go to the Edge's homepage at www.theedgean.com and look for the link under our main TV player. We are looking for Edge correspondents. Just click that and the information will appear on your computer screens. If you're interested in becoming part of this Thursday show, just go to the Edge's homepage and under the correspondence link you'll see another link called Submit Your Thursday Show Material. Here you can send us an audio, you can send us a written report, a song or a prose. We will broadcast them for you on the Edge radio broadcast and TV. We also have a news page which is continually updated, and on this news section you will see a link called News Hotline. If you click this, you can send an email straight to the Edge's news editorial desk. Now here's Frank Lordy with the holographic rapture.
The rapture is one of the most controversial topics in all of theology. Some Christians believe in it. All atheists mock it, and the New World Order may very well attempt to fake it. What would discourage Christians more than seeing New Agers, Buddhists, cult leaders, and corrupt con artist Christians raptured, while the Bible-believing faithful are, in essence, left behind? Why wouldn't the New World Order attempt to unite all the world's religions behind one deity by including them all in such an apocalyptic event? Surprisingly, the U.S. government actually admits to thinking about the use of this technology, though it denies it's followed through with such implementation. In an article entitled Bees on the Battlefield and Other U.S. Military Experiments, published by the British news agency The Guardian on June 18, 2007, it discusses strange government projects, and I quote, "Then there's the prophet hologram, the projection of the image of an ancient god over an enemy capital, whose public communications have been seized and used against it in a massive psychological operation." An Israeli cybernetics expert named Yitzhak Hayutman has even gone as far as to lobby the Arab world to allow him to project a holographic temple above the Dome of the Rock in an effort to summon whichever savior should take notice of it and actually show up. But does it even matter? Does this technology even exist? Or is it just crazy conspiracy theory? Let's take a look at the Army Research Lab Adelphi, Maryland's progress report from November 96 through August 97. Accession number ADA-333-8490. The topic? A 3D holographic display using strontium barium niobate. Its abstract states, an innovative technique for generating a three-dimensional holographic display using strontium barium niobate is discussed. The resultant image is a hologram that can be viewed in real time over a wide perspective or field of view. The holographic image is free from system-induced aberrations and has a uniform high quality over the entire field of view. Interesting. Well, we've seen the...